Hello, my name is Greg Higgins, and I'm the Senior Systems Engineer here at Environmental Lights. And in this video, we're going to talk about how to choose the right power supply for your LED lighting project. Now, this can seem daunting. However, I promise it's much easier than you would think. All right, so you've selected the best lights for your project. Now we need to select a power supply that matches the needs for your system. The following steps will put you on the path to
power supply MECCA.
First, let's start with the voltage. It's very important to use the exact voltage the LEDs were designed to operate at. Any voltage applied outside of this range can cause damage to the lights and may create a safety hazard. If you're not sure what voltage your lights are operating at, check the package. Our labels nearly always list the proper operating voltage. At Environmental Lights, our products will typically operate at one of three voltages: 5 volts DC, 12 volts DC, and 24 volts DC. Keep in mind, the majority of our products operate at constant DC voltage. This is far different than fluctuating AC voltage, similar to what you'd find on your typical landscape lighting system. It's important we do not mix the two. Now, second, we want to choose between a dimming power supply and a non-dimming power supply. We could dive deep into the differences, but I'll make it simple. If you plan on dimming your lights from a wall-mounted switch or home automating dimming system, you're going to need to go with a dimming power supply. For all other circumstances, use a non-dimming power supply. This includes not dimming at all or using a simple on-off switch, color-changing lights, wide-adjustable lights, dimming or changing the color of your lights with a remote control, and dimming or changing the color using a more complex DMX system. If you use a dimming power supply, be sure to use a compatible dimmer. These can be found in our accessories tab on each of the power supply's product description pages. If you're unsure about which dimmer to use, give us a call, and one of our engineers will be happy to point you in the right direction. Now, if you're going with a non-dimming power supply, you will choose between a few. There's adapters, which are simpler, smaller option that can be plugged directly into an outlet. There are the enclosed power supplies, which can be hardwire and typically have larger capacities. Our waterproof power supplies are designed to operate outdoors or in damp environments, but they should never be submerged in water for any duration of time. Lastly, our adjustable voltage power supplies, which are used for fine-tuning voltages in large television studios or other areas where switching noise can be detected. I would like to note that our waterproof power supplies are often used in dry applications for a couple reasons. Number one, they're smaller than the non-waterproof power supplies. And number two, they're silent. Non-waterproof power supplies over 150 watts typically have a built-in cooling fan that can make some noise. Now, in a bar or louder environment, this may not make any difference. However, in a kitchen or quiet study, you may want to opt for a waterproof power supply rather than living with a constant humming noise in the background. Now, the last step in choosing the power supply is selecting the proper size. This is one of the most important aspects to cover because it's often done incorrectly. Now, when sizing power supplies, it is industry standard to derate their capacity by 20%. This is done for good reason. Imagine driving your car down the street with the pedal to metal 100% of the time. Your car wouldn't last too long. When we choose our power supplies, we want to take the total watts being consumed by our lights and divide this number by 80%. The result will give us the smallest power supply we could safely use in our system. For example, if we calculate our total wattage to be 100 watts, we then need to divide that by 0.8, giving us a total of 125 watts. The next size power supply in our selection is 150 watts, so we choose this option. It's that easy. With any project, large or small, please feel free to give us a call. Our engineers will be happy to take a second look at your materials or help you build the entire project from the ground up. We're always happy to help.